Welcome to episode 5 of our Passage to Eastern Europe vlog with Viking River Cruises. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. Cruising overnight from Bulgaria, we woke to a morning approach to the Iron Gate Gorge. The Iron Gate is not a physical piece of hardware, but is the name given to the gorge which separates this area of Serbia and Romania. At the southern end of the Danube, prior to entering the gorge, there is this dam with two large hydroelectric power stations and a set of locks completed in 1972. About an hour after passing through the lock, we came to the iconic face built into the rock, a 55-meter-high carving of Dacian King Decebalus, completed in 2004. Decebalus ruled this area for 19 years at the turn of the 2nd century, and is credited for successfully fighting back Roman influence in the region. When the Romans caught up to him in 106 AD, he committed suicide rather than be captured. After discharging passengers going on morning tours, we continued upriver. Arriving in Golubac at dusk, we were treated to an evening tour of the Golubac Fortress situated adjacent to where we were docked. Note the tour guide sign or lollipop Viking lift you're about to see. A few weeks prior to this cruise, a malfunctioning lock near Bratislava, Slovakia, prevented Viking Lift, our originally scheduled ship, from sailing to this part of the Danube, so Viking Vidar, already in the region, was swapped with Viking Lift. Inexplicably, Viking Cruises required its program directors to carry the original itinerary's lollipops to their new ships, rather than leave existing signage alone. It is the only inefficient decision I've ever known Viking Cruises headquarters to make.
I will be your host today, and I really I expect that you will have a great time here.
Golubac Fortress was built in the 14th century and, owing to its strategic point along the river, was not only excellent at defense, but also as a collector of taxation for river traffic in the area. After World War I, a road was constructed through the castle to make it easier to pass on land along the Danube. That road was closed after trucks eventually began to wear down the castle's gates. Our guide was very passionate about how important the book is to Serbian heritage. Miroslav's Gospel, a 12th century manuscript now in the hands of the National Museum of Serbia, was stored here during part of the 19th century. A traveling Russian bishop named Porfirius appropriated a few pages from the book while visiting here in 1846. Calling himself God's bee, he felt it was his duty to travel and bring beautiful things, he called honey, back to Russia. At time of recording, diplomatic retrieval efforts are still underway, as those pages remain in Russia. The next morning, we arrived in Belgrade, Serbia. Thank you. After a short drive to the city center, we had a walking tour of Kalemegdan Park and Fortress. The park has many statues honoring war allies and literary greats. The fortress, built in the 3rd century, saw military action through World War II, and still retains some of that wartime equipment left behind by both Axis and Allied forces. We next had a bit of a wander at a downtown section directly across the street from the park. Then it was on to the Church of St. Sava. The Church of St. Sava is an Eastern Orthodox church which can hold up to 10,000 worshippers. Though construction began in 1935, ensuing wars and conflicts prevented its completion until 2004. The 3,500 square meter structure includes an impressive interior of over 50 million tiles, the majority of which contain gold, which line the main dome, 18 semi-domes, and dazzling mosaics covering the interior. Back on board, the chef had prepared dinner featuring local Serbian cuisine.
Very good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much for coming to the lounge. I do apologize for my outfit, but I told you that tonight we'll try to recreate a Balkan party here. To be honest, I'm more happy here on the Lower Danube when we have this special night than when we are in Germany and I have to wear leather hosen.
Put your hands together for our executive chef, Jan.
Thank you very much.
And we have one of the sexiest maître d' on the river. She's very shy.
We hope you've enjoyed our tour of Serbia. Please consider subscribing to our channel and giving this video a like. Thank you. In our next episode, we explore Croatia and begin our exploration of Hungary. Thank you for watching.